Well, hi there. Welcome to Bella's Vistas. Please like, subscribe, share it with your friends. While we're bidding fond farewell to our eagle's nest, I just love these majestic birds. We're headed down the road. We're going to take back roads. We're going to go through Orangeville. We're going to drive through the Holland Marsh and avoid the 401 traffic. I mean, that's just awful boring. I don't really appreciate it. Here's the Holland Marsh. Beautiful to watch all these crops growing here. This is where the carrots and vegetables come to Kitchener from. Buffer and bank stabilization project at work here. Here's the sprinkler system. That made me feel so nice and cool seeing that. It's sure not cool work being out in the fields here, but these people are used to this type of work. They've got some machinery to help with it, but it's still good hard work. We're getting close to the dark sky park now. Sun's going down. Just going to have a wonderful evening here photographing the stars. Probably stay there all night. A goldfinch here chirping away. Beautiful pose for me. There's lots of songbirds around here too. We heard whippoorwills chirping all night long. Here's the setup I'm going to be using tonight. I've got the OM-1 EM-1 Mark II with the 7-14mm. Got my OM-1 with the 300 and the 2X, the MC22X converter. Got a little radio slave on there because what I'm going to do, I'm going to do an HD picture, like an 80 megapixel of the moon. Came out pretty well, I think. This is the way the dark sky park is now with the new LED lights to light up the path, and the deck is really nice. There's my gear set up at the end of the path. Towards morning, the Milky Way was looking like this. It was really nice. Now, Tim set me up to photograph these nebula off in the distance. There's a couple edits on the nebula stack that Mary did. This one here is pushed way too far. That's no good at all. That's what happens if you just get heavy-fisted. Now, this is the Pinwheel Galaxy. I was delighted to be able to get a picture of the Pinwheel Galaxy with the nebula right in it. Decided to do some time-lapse on the stars. I wanted to get a time-lapse. Here you can see the stars rotating around the pole star. That's Polaris right in the middle. Here's our van. Beautiful birds singing in the background here. This was just fabulous. This is the view towards Polaris. And here again, the stars are rotating around Polaris. You can see very well what's happening here. And this, Mary made an edit of all the pictures, put them in Lightroom and Photoshop, and made the star trails here. I really enjoy this. You see Polaris dead center in the middle and all the stars rotating around Polaris. It's just fantastic. Again, another shot of the Milky Way towards morning. And there's our van. The sun's starting to come up. This is pushed pretty hard too. That's a bit too pixelated and everything. Well, we're leaving now, and the GPS took us on a little bit of an involved route here. We got to see some scenery that we hadn't counted on, driving across this nice old bridge here. We're at Burleigh Falls. Wow, I've been coming here for like over 40 years, making photographs here and video. It's very crowded now. It's not like it used to be. But I can still get some good shots if I position myself properly to keep the people out of the pictures. It's a fishing sanctuary. There shouldn't be any fishing allowed here. It's like preserving the fish, but people fish anyway. Beautiful pictures. I'm loving it here. There's two lakes, a waterfall, and a connecting passage between the two lakes. Bird flying by in the distance. Now we're driving through Algonquin Park. While we're up this far, I thought we might as well see if we could see any wildlife. You might see a moose, a black bear, a wolf. I've seen all of them here over the years. First came here really young with my one uncle brought up some of the cousins and me, and we camped out up there. It was a lot of fun. Wait a minute, what's here? We better check this out. Just pull off here. I think this is Brewer Lake. Gonna pull in here and see. Maybe this fella's watching a moose. He might be. No fishing. Now that's how I've spotted a lot of my moose when other people saw them first. This is the only wildlife I saw in the park, this little chipmunk, and he made such a ruckus in the leaves that I had to look at him. I think this little chipmunk likes to pose for pictures up on top of this rock. And we're back on the road again. Now we're looking for a place. Mary remembered a place that we'd seen called the Bolton Badlands. And we're going to look for that and see if we can't find it here. New paved road here. This is starting to look like it's where the GPS says it is. Yeah, 1695 to park there. Wow. We're not going to do that. I'm just going to slow down a bit here and get a peek at it. When we first came here, when the kids were little, you could go in there and walk around and tour all around there. It kind of reminds me of the Wave in Arizona, you know, towards the Fiery Furnace and the Wave, where you can get some amazing pictures there. And this is pretty similar to that, really. I mean, might have been worth going down there, but I don't really think so. Look at this house, like a spaceship. Wow. Amazing. So we made a U-turn. We're going to drive back here and see if we can see anything different than what we did. And it's pretty amazing. You can see how much area it encompasses. It's a lot like the Badlands in Alberta, too, or near Drumheller. And, well, we're back on the road again. We'll see what we can see on the way home. The walkway there, well, that kind of spoils it for photography for me, but that's the way of it. Now we're stopping at a little lake here for a photograph. We're getting very close to my osprey nest now, where I like to hang out. We're going to spend some time there. A ring-billed gull right here. Osprey flying by. Well, now, thanks for visiting Bella's Vistas. Please like, subscribe. Come on back again real soon.